get switched up. Like, comment, and subscribe. Yeah. Get with it or get rolled over, man. In the 79, cruising through the city. Two-tone paint job, ain't nobody fucking with it. Aero coupe up on the window, no need to get it tinted. Them white folks see me, it's a nigga up in it. Swerving through the marketplace, hitting all of the switches. Trump steady rallying, cause that motherfucker hit it. 13 to the concrete, you know I keep it spinning. Like dancing, like we playing with the switches. The earning plaque, you had to switch it up and had to sit. Hit that like, comment, subscribe, and check that 68 business. 78 up on the wind, bro. Ain't short until it's finished.
What up, YouTube? Back again with another one. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's your boy Switched Up 26. We back with part two of the chop, man. Part two of the chop, man. As you can see, we starting our cuts, man. The boy been grinding, like I said. First episode, we got everything tore down. Got everything out. I've been grinding, man. Like, literally grinding, man. Look at all this dirt and grime came off the bottom of this car. Yes, sir, y'all. But let me let you get a creeper eye view of it, man. Lay down on the creeper for you, y'all. Look how clean I got that thing, man. Yes, sir. I got that thing crazy cleaned up under there, man. Most of it was surface rust, oil, and dirt. So we got her all off there, man. But yeah, man. While we was off camera anyway, man, we been grinding, working, getting it all clean. I ain't think y'all want to see the boring stuff. What's up, Steve? Well, here we go back. About to start our cut. Got a hole marked. Y'all want to remember, man, when y'all going E64s, the springs, the shocks was tilted like this, man. So you want to bring your what you call it straight up and down. So your cylinder will stand straight up into the pocket, y'all. Mm. So keep that in mind if you chopping a 64. You don't never want to follow that existing hole for the shock. Cause it's gonna be laying, your cylinder is gonna be in your pocket like that. You want that cut straight down, man. See how that match up with the drill? You want that joint straight down like that, man. So your cylinder is straight up. And you don't have no problem, man. So, man, y'all basically see where we're going. All the noise about to start. So, y'all take a moment right now, though, man. Hit that subscribe button. Hit your post notification bell so you stay up to date. Give me a thumbs up. Keep it locked.
All right, guys, and we back, man. It's been about a week since we made the cuts, first initial cuts on the 64. So we got the front cuts done. Got the got everything grinded down and clean, ready for paint. Just gotta hit it with a little bit of degreaser, clean it up a little bit, so we can get her sprayed. We got our control arms in. We did have to end up ordering control arms, y'all. The bushings, when we was pushing the bushings out, it was collapsing the arms, and things been in there so long, it was just collapsing the arms. So my dude that I outsourced it to said, you might as well just go ahead and get another set, because they will be crushed in trying to get those bushings out of those control arms, man. So that's what we did. We went ahead and ordered another set. But now, man, we're going ahead. We're jumping straight into the back now, man. Already got it up off jack stands. Got it in the air. We're about to go ahead and start dropping down the springs and the shocks, and so we can get ready to start grinding and cleaning up, man, getting ready for this paint as well on the rear, and then make our cuts. So we've been here for a little bit this morning already, man. So it's a Saturday morning. I'm just knocking out stuff, man, as fast as I can, y'all. I'm staying busy, as I say. Man, I just came in this morning, man. Pulled the transmission out of that truck right there. That little black Mazda, man. Got that transmission sit down on the ground. Customer purchased this from a junkyard, and it's no good, y'all. So had to pull it back out. And we basically got it sitting here waiting for transport, man. Waiting for him to come pick it up and get it down, man. Just like I said too, man, your boy, we ordered a new lift, man. That new lift just came in earlier this week. Waiting on my guy to come set it up for me, man. Drill the hole, set it up for me. So, but we're gonna jump into the 64 this morning, man, as well, man. Try to get some of this knocked out. Ain't gonna be here all Saturday morning, but try to get some of it done. But yeah, man, y'all take a moment right now though, man. Hit that subscribe button, hit your post notification bell so you stay up to date on what we got going on, and give me a like button as well, man. Share it, man. Let some folks know what we got going on in 2-6. So keep it locked, and we're about to get going on this, man. Yes, sir. All right, gang. So we got the shocks down, springs out, man. I'm sitting here looking at these cups, y'all. I gotta sit here and figure that out. You never seen that set up before. This is my first time on a 64, so I guess that's a different feature they had for 64. I don't know if those are on my 63 right there. Don't remember. But yeah, we got the springs and the shocks out. Just assembled both sides. Now we're gonna start grinding. Pull the grind out. We're gonna start grinding. Get all some of this grime and stuff up off here. I need to spray these wet collars down, matter of fact. Let me do that just in case these suckers, these got bolts on them. These might come off. Probably one up under the bottom. But let's hit those real quick. But yeah, we're gonna turn on the grinder. Start knocking some of this grime off, get ready. Repaint this sucker, touch it up. No, I ain't leaving it nasty like that, bro. Not doing it. Gotta touch it up. So when she up in the air, you see a clean rear end, No dirt, just fresh paint. Yes, sir. It got to happen. So that's what we're going to do, man. But keep it locked. Turn back on in a second.
All right, guys. We back, man. So like I said, we got everything broke down, man. Let me say, I don't know if we got the time lapse. I did have a time lapse on grinding down the rear end and getting the cups off for the coils, and I also done cut one side of the little pocket, the little cup off that holds it spring in place, and we've been grinding down, man. So I don't know if the time lapse caught all that. My camera started cutting up on me. So I don't know, y'all, but this is what we got done so far, man. We've been grinding. All that dirt on the floor, that dirt and grime on the floor that came off this rear end. We still gotta go up top. We hit some of the frame already. And we've been cutting, man. So trying to get everything prepped so we can get ready to start painting. But it's going, man. We're gonna use a new type of paint today, though, man. New type of paint, man. The girls at AutoZone don't be listening. But we're gonna see what it do, man. An anti-rust, man. U-pump, anti-rust, protector enamel. So turf durable. So we're gonna see what that'll do, man. First time using that, so we're gonna see how that look, see how that comes out, man. And we're gonna go from there, man. So we still gotta cut. I still gotta cut this cup off on this side. I gotta cut this cup off on this side, and we still got a bunch of grinding to do, man. We still gotta get the top. Up here on the top, that upper control arm and the inside of the lower of the passenger side, man. Gotta get that all cleaned up and grind. Hit this panhandle bar a little bit before we touch up, before we hit it with the paint, y'all. So we getting through it, man. We getting through it, y'all. So we getting through it. So y'all take the moment right now, though, man. Hit that subscribe button, man. Hit your post notification bell so you can stay up to date on what we got going on. Give me a thumbs up and share it as well, man. Just keep it locked, man. I'm going to give you some more, man. All right, man. We back, man. It's the next day, man. So we're going to go back and been grinding. We still got a lot of more grinding to do. But we're about to go ahead and cut our rear cylinder holes, man. That's what we're about to do, man. Go ahead and cut our rear cylinder holes and see if we can get this done, man, real quick. See if we can get this done real quick, and then we're gonna go to grinding again, man. So hold on, man. I'm gonna throw you on a time lapse. Yes, sir. All right, man, already, y'all. Already, man. See that time lapse, man? It's cutting. My drill bit broke, man. My drill bit broke, bro. in the middle of the last cut. Thought I was gonna be able to get through this joker. I mean, not the last cut, the third cut. It didn't break on the freaking metal, man. It broke on the freaking aluminum, bro. Look at that crap, man. Broke on the freaking aluminum, man. See the little hole coming through? Broke on the freaking aluminum, y'all. Before I can even get started on my process today, man. It's cut me short already. Matter of fact, you know what I just thought about? I bought some drill bits when I bought that hole saw for metal. So I might be in business, y'all. So, man, hold on real quick, man. But y'all take a second right now, man. Hit that subscribe button, man. Hit your post notification bell so you stay up to date on what we got going on. Give me a thumbs up, man, and share it as well, man. Send this link to somebody, bro. Hold on. We're going to turn you back on in just a second. YouTube, man. We back, man. We back, bro. Going through it right now, man. So a minute ago, we broke a drill bit on the hole saw, man. And I bought some extra drill bits for this purpose because I know drill bits break. But, man, I done stuck them things somewhere. I put them in a safe spot so I wouldn't lose them, YouTube. A safe spot. And you know how that go. That safe spot, I done hit them from myself, man. I done straight hit them from myself, cuz I don't know where them drill bits at, man. So after about 30 minutes, I done got frustrated and I done started on to something else, man. I'm gonna go to Lowe's on the way to the house today or first thing in the morning, get some new drill bits and start fresh on the holes in the morning, man. So that's where we at on that, man. But I just stopped looking for the bits, man, and jumped on something else, man. So I started grinding. Still cleaning, man. We still cleaning. Cleaned out the back of the hub assembly. Try to get that clean. Put some paint on there. Already done did one side. So we ain't gonna let the drill bit slow us down, man. So here go the other side, y'all. So we got one side done already, man. I'ma touch up. That's one coat of paint. I'ma hit it again. After that, tack up and dry a little bit. But yeah, man. Like I said, man, we got through. Look, there on my drill bit right there. Broke off, snap off. So, got through the metal, and then the blade broke on the darn aluminum, man. It broke on the aluminum, man. I don't know if you can see that. Oh, my light off. I done took my light from up under there. You ain't gonna be able to see the hole now. But yeah, man. So that's where we at, man. So I'm gonna finish grinding on this a little bit more so I can get this side tacked up and painted a little bit, looking a little bit better. She looking a little bit better, man. Yes, sir. So that's all we at, man. That's where we at, man. I'm gonna just keep grinding and touching up this paint. So I ain't gotta do that tomorrow, I guess. So that's what we're gonna focus on today, man. So that's where we at, man. Lost drill bits. I'm gonna, about to throw another coat of paint. I'm gonna throw paint on this hub right here, and then I might look for these drill bits again, man. Oh man, I forgot, y'all. I'm working on, I got a lot of things going on, man. Working on a car, man. Working on a Dodge Caravan, man. And this thing had so many freaking leaks, y'all. I had to replace the whole damn cooling system, man. Got a metal hose down there on the bottom that runs from the radiator hose to the back of the block. That whole thing, it had a cracked rust hole in it. Put that on, that thing built pressure. Radiator started leaking. Threw the radiator in there, man. And then the water pump started leaking, man.
That thing was leaking from everywhere, bro. But look at this motor. This thing is nasty. This thing got a hell of oil leak too. I'm gonna notify the customer of that when they come pick it up, man. But they got it. They brought it here from overheating. So she been holding temperature, man, for a little minute now, man. So I'm just doing my due diligence and making sure she gonna hold, man. So like I said, we ain't just working on the 64 today, man. We got a lot of things going on. I'm dolo in the shop today, so, but ain't gonna stop nothing. Ain't gonna stop nothing. We gonna keep grinding, man. Gonna keep grinding. So, probably next thing I turn you on for be probably first thing in the morning when I start cutting, man. So y'all hold on, man. I'm gonna turn you back on in just a sec. All right, YouTube, we back, man. It's the next day, man. Like I said yesterday, man, we broke the bid. I went to Lowe's this morning, man, and got a new drill bit for the hole saw. Got me a couple other blades that I need. And, man, I grabbed this big old can, man. I've been seeing these online, man. I wanted to see how this little Rustola turbo can work, man. It's a big old can, y'all. And for the price, you can't beat it, man. For the price, you can't beat it. It was like 15 bucks, man. So we're gonna finish. I need to get some more paint anyway. We about got everything looking presentable. Got everything about looking presentable, y'all. So she decent. She looking way better than she did. Way better than she did. That's for sure. Way better than she did. So then we're gonna run with that. About to jump back in it real quick and continue to cut these holes, man. Get these last two holes. Well, yeah, last two holes finished. I gotta go through the aluminum on this side, and then I gotta go through both sides over there. So we're gonna run like that, man, and this morning try to get this wrapped up, and we're gonna go from there, y'all. So I'm gonna turn you on time lapse. I'm probably just finished knocking out this side, and then I'm gonna hit you on the time lapse on the other side. We're gonna go from there, man. Start and hit it with the paint again, finish coating everything, and then we're gonna start going back together. Like I said, we got new control arms, upper and lower for the 64, man. Lowers is in the box, ain't took those out yet. Yes, sir. First bushings, ball joints, everything, man. So about ready to throw our fittings in our cylinders. One more fittings in the cylinders. And get ready to start slapping that back together, man. So it ain't gonna take long to put that back together. Longest point probably gonna be me cutting and painting, man. So we got a lot of that on this video, man. So honestly, I might not even turn you back on while I'm doing this, man. I might hit you finish painting, cut the holes, and then finish painting, man, and then jump back on the front. So jump back on the front so we can get that put together, man. We gotta get this car back on the ground, y'all. I wanna see how low she sit, man. I think my man's gonna have to do some modifications to this exhaust, because this thing got long tube headers on it, y'all. You see the headers right there, and the muffler is sitting way low. Like way low. So he definitely gonna have to, I think he's gonna crush them with, gonna cause the car not to sit all the way down, man. Honestly, my opinion. So we gonna see though, man. We gonna see, y'all. So so turn you off, turn you back on, man. Let me get started, knock out these few little things, man. And I'm gonna turn you back on in a few minutes, man.
Turbo Dan, what's up? Who would it do?
I lay all my burdens on the Trinity. Separate yourself from every entity, so you can operate God's energy. A lot of demons trying to get to me, only to pretend that they are friends of me. Separate yourself from every enemy, so you can operate.
Joint laying out, coming out a lot, y'all.
I was expecting to be this wide. That thing's stupid wide.
You laying on nice. Wish y'all have seen this first. Now let me knock this out, man. Get this turbo can, and I'm gonna turn you back on. All right, you two, we back, man. Hello.
All right, man. So we back, man. We got our power balls. We got our cylinders, cups, locking plates, everything in place, man. We got to touch up our paint a little bit after them welds. But we got the rear end all done, man. Yes, sir. Got the rear end all done. Starting up mock-up for our trunk. Front end got to go back together. Still ready. Front end got to go back together, y'all. So, we working, man. 64 coming together, man. Yes, sir. Y'all make sure y'all like, follow. Go to my YouTube. Video gonna be dropping. Yes, sir. So, man, it's gonna be a wrap for this episode. Next episode gonna be us throwing the I probably won't get the front end going back together. Y'all pretty much know how that go. Gotta lock our wheel assembly back on, throw our cylinder, our cup. We got deep cups and our 3.5-ton springs, man, and then close up. So probably won't get that on camera. Show you what it look like though when we get it done. Next episode gonna be us throwing this designing our trunk, man. So I think I'm gonna go with eight battery setup, 4 on each side. I got 3. I need to grab another one, man, so I can make sure this clearance is gonna fit. But other than that, man, yes sir, y'all see cylinders is up through the holes, man. So we just gotta keep going, man. So but y'all take a moment right now though, man. Hit that subscribe button, man. Hit your post notification bell so you stay up to date on what we got going on. Give me a thumbs up and share it as well, man. Let these boys know what we got going on down here in the 2-6, man. Yes, sir, man. Yes, sir. She gonna be sitting low, man. She gonna be sitting low. Yes, sir, man. So, I'll catch y'all next time, man. I appreciate y'all for watching, man. And we'll catch you on the next episode, man. We out.